What's the difference between an oceanographer and a marine biologist?
So an oceanographer, so oceanography just means study of the ocean. Do you know what biology means?
No.
So biology, bio means life. So biology is the study of life. And marine biology, marine means ocean. So
the study of the ocean?
Study of life in the ocean.
What did you study?
So in graduate school, my main study was on phytoplankton.
Yeah, they're the smallest thing.
So those are the tiny little organisms that live in the ocean. There's two kinds of plankton.
There's the zooplankton.
Very good.
The other kind, I forgot.
Phytoplankton.
Okay. So did you study other things besides phytoplankton?
Well, the thing about science is everything is connected. So I was studying the plants that live in the ocean, but to understand the plants, you have to understand their environment. So they have nutrients, food. The plants need things to grow. They need the sun. You have to know whether the water is mixed up or not. You have to know if there's food in the water for the plants to eat. And then the plants get eaten by the zooplankton, so you have to know about them. And the zooplankton get eaten by the bigger things.
Yeah, like the
whales.
Blue whale.
Yeah.
Blue whale.
So even if you're studying one part of it, you need to work on and understand many other parts. So there's two kinds of whales, right, James?
Yeah, the tooth whale and the baleen whale.
That's correct. So what do the tooth whales eat?
They eat the blue whale, or they eat the seal, or they eat all the other stuff.
Yeah, so they eat kind of big animals, right? Seals,
yeah.
They're the meat eaters. Squid. What do the baleen whales eat, and how do they do that?
They eat fish, and when they open their mouth when they get to the Arctic or the Antarctic, and they go like, and then all the krill or something goes in, and then the baleen basically takes all the water out, and then he eats it.
So it's like a filter.
Yeah.
So basically they eat anything that gets stuck on the baleen, right?
How big is the tallest mountain in Antarctica?
I don't know the name of the tallest mountain, but a famous mountain is actually an active volcano, and it is very tall. It's called Mount Erebus. Antarctica is 1.5 times bigger than the United States. So if you have the United States, you need 1.5. You need the United States and another half of the United States. That's how big Antarctica is.
Oh, that's pretty big.
Yeah, so it's big.
What's your favorite Antarctic animal?
My favorite Antarctic animal has to be penguins.
Do you have a Pacific type that you like?
Yes, emperor penguins.
How did you bring the penguins to SeaWorld?
That's another great question. All of them were hatched right here.
What is the funniest thing the orca has done?
The funniest thing? Well, one of our juvenile males, Trua, he's 8 years old, and I was taking a photo for a family, and he bumped the glass just to scare them, and then stuck his tongue out. It was pretty silly.
What is the awesomest thing about killer whales?
Awesomest thing is seeing them born here at SeaWorld. In my 8 years here, I've gotten to see a couple of the killer whales born, and it's really neat when we have a new killer whale calf born. We have 6 and 7 year old girls, Malia and Nalani, and then our 3 year old male, Makayo. I've seen all three of them from there.
Oh, Makayo's in the show.
Mm-hmm.
In the big blue world, I'm gonna go explore. In the big never seen before.
That's what I'm afraid of.
Hey, Dad, do you know how old sea turtles are?
Sea turtles? I don't know.
Sandy Plankton said they could live to be 100.
Well, if I ever meet one, I'll ask him.
Me too. Maybe I'll meet a sea turtle and a shark.
No need to worry, Dad. I'll be okay.
I'm scared you'll end up as a clownfish fillet. We can turn right around. We could wait one more year.
Don't be so boring, Dad.
I belong here.
Yep.
Sure is.
What's wrong with his fin?
Be nice. It's his first day of school.